So here, you can see we've got a very thin foil sample of dysprosium. Again, it's from the bottom end of the periodic table. Very, very reactive. Stored very, very carefully as a foil. Now if we open very carefully, we might see if the metal's still there.
Okay, so dysprosium is used in nuclear fuel rods because it's very good at capturing neutrons, which means you can modulate how hot a nuclear reaction is getting, which is why it's used in power stations to prevent the reactions from running away out of control.
So take off all of this foil, and then we can withdraw the sample. So it's in this really quite nice paper. So is the sample still there? Oh, beautiful. Here we see this wonderful sample of dysprosium.
If you mix dysprosium with cadmium and sulfur, it can be used in devices which produce infrared beams. Now, chemists use infrared beams quite a lot because when you irradiate a sample, a compound with infrared, then certain absorbances will occur which are specific to stretching or bending modes which the molecule will do. And this is a way of therefore scanning molecules and getting some information about their composition and structure.
Oh, beautiful foil.
Do you happen to know anything about this element?
Not a thing. That's Steve's domain.
Yeah.